We are going to start this bridge course for physics in class 11. Some basic mathematics you are supposed to know. In that, one very important topic is quadratic equations. Often, while doing physics numericals, you come across these quadratic expressions. So you should know how to calculate the roots and take the appropriate roots as the solution. So any equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. It has got two roots, and the solution will be minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. This a, b, c are the coefficients of the unknown. Unknown here is x. A, b, c are the constants. So this root over b square minus 4ac is called discriminant, denoted by delta. There are three possible cases. Delta can be greater than 0, equal to 0, or less than 0. When delta is greater than 0, the roots are real and they are not equal. Both the roots will not be equal to each other. When delta is equal to 0, the roots are real and they are equal. And when delta is less than 0, the roots are not defined. They are unreal. So let us see some examples regarding this. The first one, minus x square plus x plus 2 is equal to 0. So we can observe a is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to 2. Find out delta. Putting this formula, you get 9. 9 is greater than 0, so the roots are real and not equal. So we can find the roots. Minus 1 plus or minus root over 9 by 2 into a 2 into minus 1. If you solve, you get 2 and minus 1. So you got two roots and both are unequal. Let us see another example. 6 root 5x square minus 9x minus 3 root 3 is equal to 0. Note down, this is my a, this is my b, and this is my c. If you find the delta value here, putting b square minus 4ac, you get this much value, which exactly, if you calculate, you get approximately 360, which is greater than 0. So the roots, do they exist? Yes, and they are basically unequal. See, here when we are doing physics problems, you don't have to convert that into cert and all the time. You can put approximate numerical values, okay, and get the exact value also, and see whichever is close to the options. So when you exactly solve this, so minus b plus or minus root over this value divided by 2a, and when you solve this, you get plus or minus two roots. One is 1.4, one is minus 0.37. okay, decimal values we got. You can convert this into a third also, and you can do that. But basically here the idea is to calculate the roots of the equation. Okay, let us see one more example. Example 3, x square minus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. Here we can solve the quadratic roots by the method of factorization. The method is, you take the multiple of a and c. So it is 12 here. Write it in the form of, you should write in such a way that the product of two numbers should be 12. So 3 into 4 is there, and minus 3 minus 4 is minus 7. So this b term you should be able to write as a sum of two numbers, and c term should be ac, a multiplied by c, you should be able to write it as product of two numbers. So here minus 4x minus 3x is 7x minus 7x, and you take x common here, x into x minus 4, and if you take minus 3 common here, 3 minus 3 into x minus 4. So you can just open and see, minus 3x, minus 3 into minus 4, it is plus 12. So if you take the x minus 4 as common, you get x minus 3 into x minus 4 is equal to 0, or x is equal to 3 and 4. Okay, so you got two roots. So method of factorization is another method of arriving at roots. You can find out the discriminant value here. Discriminant value will be 7 square minus 4 into 1 into 12. So this is 49 and this is 48. It is 1. It is greater than 0. That is why you got two distinct roots. We can see another example. X square minus 12x plus 32 is equal to 0. If you factorize, you get x minus 8 into x minus 4 is equal to 0. So this is one method. Another method is using this formula which we have discussed earlier. This is formula approach. If you do that, minus b plus or minus root over discriminant value, b square 144 minus 4 into a is 1 and c is 32. So if you solve this, you get 12 plus or minus root over 16 by 2, and when you solve, you get 8 and 4. So whether you use the formula or you use the factorization method, you get the same answers. You need to decide which is more quick and which is more appropriate to the question given. Let us see one more example. 9x square minus 30x plus 25 is equal to 0. So if you find the discriminant value here, you are getting 0. That means the roots will be real and they will be equal. So if you calculate, you get 30 plus or minus root over 0 by 2 into a, which is 9. You get 5 by 3, 1.67. You can apply the method of factorization also. How you will multiply? See, 9, 25 is 225. Okay? And you know that 15 square is equal to 225. But 15 plus 15 is how much? 30. So you can write it as 9x square minus 15 minus 15, it is minus 30, and 25 into 9 is 225. So you take out 3x common here, you get 3x minus 5, and you take minus 5 common here, you take 3x minus 5. So it reduces to 3x minus 5 into 3x minus 5 is equal to 0. So you got, even though you got two roots, but they are both equal. Thank you.